He showed a lot of promise as far as schooling, that is, his testing was concerned. Not that he was that great a student, but he qualified for that gifted schooling system they have in Milwaukee.
He dropped out of high school because he thought he didn't learn anything there.
His main asset is really just his mouth, his talking, and he can be pretty convincing, you know, because he's very assertive, very aggressive. And but what he actually can do, I think that he's just best suited for working in a factory, maybe.
When he decided to join the Army, I think that was not only a decision to get away from here, but to try to straighten out his life. And that didn't work too well.
And Mark moved back from the Army and said, you know, let's make another film, you know, and made a couple other shorts, you know, from there. And then along came Covan.
This is ridiculous. We started May 94, man. We've got every F-stop known to man in the film. And right now, we got to take action, man. We got to go out to that field, put those scarecrows in on a killer slant. You know, they've been there for years. The farm's burnt down. It's going to be the opening shots for Covan, you know?
And what is Covan?
Covan's a 35-minute direct market thriller film shot on 16-millimeter black and white reversal. It's an alcoholic, man, compelled to go to this group meeting by his one and only friend left, but they're not that helpful to group, you know? You know about the group thing?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what we're doing a film on. Covan, man, we gotta get this sucker done, though, seriously. Last night, man, I was so drunk, I was calling Morocco, man, calling, trying to get to the Hotel Hilton at Tangiers in Casablanca, man. That's pathetic, man. Is that what you wanna do with your life? Suck down peppermint schnapps and try to call Morocco at 2 in the morning? That's senseless, but that's what happens, man. So anyway, we're out here today to try to redeem it, get these establishing shots for Covan, and, you know, do what you can. You know, we're in America today, and we're ready to roll. One, two, three. But check it out, Mike. Now, do you know about the placement of the scarecrows? What they're doing here? Like, one's got to be, like, on this angle, and then the other one's going to be on the other angle. And check it out when you look at the scarecrows. Do you see? You get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
We did a lot of fun things making the movie. We one time we brought Mark's car into a vacant drive-through theater, took iron rods and smashed up his car. And then another time we dragged Mark like head first through a swamp like 25 times.
Covan relates to Northwesters in this sense. If I don't go into the black with Covan, if I don't make money back off of Covan, how the hell am I going to make Northwestern? I've got to make money back on Covan. So when I did these figures, 500, 1,000, 2,000, and 3,000 units, right? I said, check this out. Fuck this, man. I'm sorry for erasing that, but it's 3,000 units for 45 grand. Because if I don't get that 45 grand, man, I will not be shit. So there's no 500 copies, there's no 1,000, there's no 2,000. There's fucking 3,000 to be sold. Because if I don't get that, I will never get the ability to make Northwestern. You're signing for it because those checks are going to be in Northwest Productions' name and 3,000 plus interest if you want it.
Northwestern's name.
That's the title of the company. That's who the checks get made out to. $3,000 of those checks goes to you. You get your $3,000 back.
Doesn't sound very kosher to me.
Okay,
just make sure they're endorsed Northwest Productions.
Northwest Productions, okay.
And put into that.
And he's the only name on it, Willis Borchardt.
How am I going to know about all this that you're doing?
Because it cannot leave the account without your signature.
I don't know what you're doing.
No, do you understand
that?
You get a statement.
No one can take anything out.
Every month. Nobody can take any money out unless you have to sign for it.
It's in your control.
Sounds like the usual.
All right.
Sounds like the unusual.
Here, you bet. Shake on it. There you have it.
Yeah, okay. Well, Columbus took a chance. Lindbergh took a chance. Have faith.
Faith on nothing.
Bill, man, you can't go out like that. You gotta be,
You gotta be upbeat.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta.
It's gonna work.
Well, the good that is.
And when you go in the grave and you're just laying there in the casket, the last hoorah, the final goodbye, what are you gonna think about, Bill? Huh?
You tell me.
Well, that's the whole deal, man. You gotta assert yourself, man, and think, I am here because. You ever think about that?
I am here because.
Hey, man, you wanna. You have 2 hours tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. and be an extra in a film? Are you sure about that, Charlie? Hey, do you know where I live? I live 2 blocks from you. All right, dude, you got a pen? Can you get a pen?
Yeah, I mean, you've seen a lot of movies, haven't you?
Yeah.
And you basically know how to frame shots?
I guess. No, not really.
But I mean, if you would see an action, you would kind of like centrifugally focus on it being in the center?
Yeah, I can figure that out, yeah.
And fuck it, man. I think my mom's going to have to end up going out in the woods. I mean, it's just one of those things.
I have my shopping to do, and I have
This is the last day I can shoot. All of the extras have just fell through, man, except for Mike Schenck right there, all right? Yes. You got to help me.
Mark, I have so much to do.
And I'm doomed.
What am I supposed to do?
Just stand there. Hey, Mike, make sure everyone has brown gloves.
Does everyone have brown gloves?
No, dude. you got...
I have some here.
Okay, yeah. Of the group of the Covan, and then I got one shot, which is a close-up of me, and then one shot of a swish right to left of a tight of a Covan member as he sees him for the first time. Yeah. Yeah, low angle, man. Gonna need somebody to scale a tree and get that snow off. Son of a fucking bitch, everybody just come up for a second, right up to the camera. I'm just gonna go wide on you. Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, this is kind of great, but it doesn't. Okay, you got to spread apart like about 5 feet each. That way? Okay, very cool.
Kenny, can you please put that soda on the tarp so it's not frozen when we're done? Because I'd like to drink it, please.
We're going to do a 5-6-8 split then. Now, you guys got to look menacing. Can you be more menacing? Oh man, all right, well, we gotta do what we can do then, I guess. All right, yeah, I think it went pretty good, but I don't want to say that until I see the footage, man, because you never know what's gonna happen. I've been out here 5 fucking times now, man, doing the same shit. But I'll fucking get this down, man, and I think with these last 4 shots, man, we might have this fucker in the can. Cut, how's that, man? Talk to me.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah, well, we can't see your beard. How's that?
You can see part of
the beard. Okay, this is the edge of the close-up, and then like...
Fuck it, you're right. Man, I go out here, just go out there, hour, 2 hours, drive around these houses, man, and it's like, okay, now I know what I'm here for again, fine, and you got that squared away. But to be serious, the American dream stays with me each and every day, and I'm glad we're doing this today because I was really getting down and out, and thank God they extended my phone bill till Friday and lowered it too. But anyway, so today, man, I'm just gonna go right back to work, man, so we can get, actually my house ain't gonna look like this, man. It's gonna be flatter, a lot flatter, less obnoxious than this.
He wants to have the good life eventually. He wants the big house and the nice car and all that, but at this point, you know, for the last, I don't know, I'd say maybe 10, 15 years, he's been delivering news.